demonstrate the Sawstop table saw activation on the new Sawstop job site saw. As many of you know, we've had cast iron saws for 10, 11 years already. So we've been doing this a long time, and a lot of guys have seen this already. But the job site saw has been out since March. And since March, we've sold over 4,000 of these units, so we're real proud of these. But we want to show you exactly how it works on the job site saw. Now, if you're not familiar with Sawstop, what we do is we stop a spinning saw blade at 5/1000ths of a second. That's 10 times faster than a car's airbag deploys. So what we're going to show you is how it works. But what I want to do is I want to point out some key features of this saw as well. The saw's brake system works with this cartridge right here. This is mounted right down below your saw blade. And what it's doing is putting a small electrical charge into the saw blade itself. And it's monitoring that for change. Your body has the ability to change an electrical signal simply by touching the saw blade. So when you touch the blade, you come in contact with the blade, you change that signal, and it activates. So this is what it looks like following an activation. As you can see, here's the before and after. That heavy-duty spring pushes that block of aluminum into the path of the blade, and the teeth of the blade dig right into that aluminum block. That stops the rotation. In addition, the arbor where the blade is mounted has a quick-release mechanism that will drive the blade down below the table. All of this occurs in 5 milliseconds. If you look on those brochures that Chris passed out, there's some small photographs on the front. That's the actual injury that an operator received from the Sawstop saw, a small scratch on their finger. That was it. Then when you have that activation, you need to change out the brake cartridge. This costs $69. That's definitely less than going to the emergency room. Okay? You change out your saw blade. Sawstop always recommends you change your saw blade. However, we've had some people that actually have sent in their saw blades for service after checking with manufacturers to see if they recommend doing that. So check with your manufacturer about your blade. Let me point out some features on this saw. You got a quick release access for your saw blade right here. One of the features, you can come in and look if you want. One of the features, some of these guys will be able to see it, is one turn elevation, one turn, and the blade comes all the way up. You're not turning it multiple times. It has a quick bevel, just like that, and it has micro adjust built into it, so you can adjust your angle. It also has a T-glide style fence, similar to a Biesmeyer fence. The table extends out 25.5 inches. You have onboard storage for a guard, a miter gauge, an extra brake, and some tools. The fence is locked in a holster right on the side, and you can unlock it, put it right up on your saw, move it over, and drop it down and lock it. Now, if you need to cut in this void area without a table, there's also an onboard shelf that you can just flip out to use to support your material, so you don't lose control of that material by slipping underneath the fence. So, I'm getting ready right here to show you how this works. When I power up the saw goes through a quick diagnostic check of the brake. It's checking to make sure that this brake is working correctly. In a few seconds, it actually gives you a green light on the switch box and you can turn your power on. So we've got a green light. We've got power. Now, if for some reason something wasn't working right, the saw will not allow you to turn your saw on if the cartridge isn't working correctly. And I'll show you what that looks like. If I'm touching that saw blade with this hot dog, it's blinking a red light. That's telling you something's wrong. I'm not going to allow power to the motor. That's resulted in a zero failure rate of the brake system in 11 years. Because we check the brake to make sure it's working before you turn the power on, before we allow you to turn the power on. Zero failure rate. It's always works. You can depend on that. Okay, let me show you how it works now. If you can't see from back here, come on the side. You want to see this. Come around here. I'm going to take the diving knife off just so you get a little better view. If you want to take a video on your phone, feel free to do it. share it with your friends. When you see this, tell people about it. I'm going to leave it raised up so you can see it. If you can't see it from back here, please get up here. Chris? Chris is here from M&M. Chris has asked if he could do this. He wants to send this hot dog through here. So we're ready to go. We got a green light. We're going to turn the power on. Hold on to the hot dog. Hold on to the board. You let it go. Power right there, yeah. Now show it to him. Show it to him. Show it. Don't walk it around. Show it to him. Come and take a look. See anything over to the side. Wasn't that amazing? Go on in to take a look.
I gotta unplug this.
Here's a plug right here.
Oh, here it is. Thank you. So we want to take a look at what it looks like inside. You can see what the activation looks like. Now, it takes 5 minutes or less to change that out. Put a new brake cartridge
on. I don't see anything either.
This part right here, $69. The saw costs $12.99. If you're rich, if you have more questions, feel free to talk to me or any of the guys at M&M, buddy. Let's get this on your job. Let's get this on your job today. There's too many people missing. How many people know someone who's already had an accident on a table saw? Right? This is not something new. Let's get this done. Thank you. Awesome. Did you find it?
I can't.
You know what I forgot to tell you is kind of leave it on the board. That way you can kind of line it up with the socket. And then you can kind of get an idea of where it might have happened.
Yeah, I didn't know that.
Yeah.
Well, like last time I did last year, I just kind of held the hot dog on this side.
Yeah.
So I was like, oh man, we're going to kind of hold it. So this time I'm
Amazing. So,